Bye, guys. Hello. इसने अभी तक ये नहीं किया शायद। Now it's live. Hi guys. So I am Chandi Mistry and I am into food photography and styling since almost a year now. And today I'm gonna show you some basics of food styling and photography. So tell me if you know anything about food photography in the comments, and also tell me where are you guys from so that I know you guys a little better, because I just joined the group a few days back and I don't know many of you guys here. Hi Vanshika. Hi Priya. Please call me Chandni and not ma'am, please. That would be better. So also tell me if you guys are able to hear me and view me properly, and if you all can see the things over here. Are you guys able to hear me? Hi. Hello everyone. So cool, so let's start. Hi Tasneem. Hi, hello. So let's start from a very basic tip. So first thing I want you all to do when you all are clicking your phone. So we are gonna learn it from a phone, not from any DSLRs, because you know the camera does not really matter. What matters is how you click the picture. So first I'm gonna show you tricks with your phones today. The first thing you do is locate your phone's camera. So I'm using a Samsung S10, so my camera is right here. So now usually I tend to leave my phone anywhere and everywhere, like it's in my pocket sometimes when it's on the tabletop. So the first thing you do is wipe your camera. You can wipe it with your t-shirt or anything or cloth around. Wipe your camera for better pictures, because or else it's gonna be blurred out and a little stainy picture. So if you think your picture is coming a little like blurry or something, you can always first clean your lens and then click again and check if that makes a difference. The second thing I'm gonna tell you all is never use your phone's flash. Never do that, because see, I'll show you a picture. If you use your own phone's flash, this is what you will observe: a lot of reflection on the dish, and you all don't want this. And if you all click it without your flash, the colors will be quite original, and that is what you all would want. Okay? So yeah, these were two basic tips. And now your camera's modes. Now every phone's camera has different modes. Most of the phones these days have a food mode. So if you all want to check the modes, you all can always go here and see the modes that you all have. So there's a food mode in my phone right here. So you all can use the food mode for better colors in your food. This would always help. The contrast is always better when you all use this mode. Okay? Now there is also a mode called live focus. Now if you all are using this live focus mode, the depth would be a little more, and the object you want to focus on will get focused, and the things around it would tend to get blurred out a little bit. Now be careful when you are using this. because then most of the times you all will blur out some important subjects in your frame and you don't want that. So be careful with this mode. And I would say actually use your phone's normal mode, or else if you all want, you all can use the food mode, which is also a better thing because it improves the color and you won't have to edit it much. So now I'm going to show you some of the props that I use. I am into this thing a lot, so I have hoarded a lot of things here, but it's not necessary that you would have all these things. You all can always click in your normal steel plate. So I also have a steel plate here, if you see. So use such kind of steel plate with this thing, so you all can put one thing here, few things here, and a garnish, a little bit of salad or something here. Like if you all are clicking a biryani picture or a pulao picture, you can always put biryani here, a little bit of raita here, and salad over here. So it would give a good thing. So these are my earthenwares, if you see. So there's a glass. There are two kinds of bowls, a small bowl and a big bowl. So which can be used for dips and maybe for some dal or curry, the bigger one. And two plates I have here. So a small plate and a big plate. And then there is this thing over here. So this is a pan I use for pulao mostly. It's for rice dish. The cover on a side like this gives a good combination. It's a wood and it really gives a good look when you potatoes or maybe Chinese noodles in it, because it's a wok in which they usually make a smaller version of. These are some of the wooden props that I use. I usually use to keep beneath, like you can look beneath that here. I'll show you my antiques. So these are all from Chor Bazaar, guys. Going to shop these from there. So the plates that I use, so this is one plate. This can be used as a normal dinner plate and you can put in rice and rotis. Even rotis can be served in this. So, and this one is kind of a tray. So when you are using this, you can use a small object with it. When you're using this, you keep it beneath and then you use, yeah. So you keep this tray beneath and then you keep a bowl on it and some ingredients and props around it and click it. You never click it on the tray, you use something over the tray and then click, yeah. The main, my favorite props. These are my favorite props, guys. These are very versatile. You can use it with anything. Like you can use it when you are using steel props. You can use it when you are using glass props. Anything. It creates a really good effect to your photo. It gives a good effect. And it's very useful. If you all don't have it at home, once the lockdown is over, you know what to shop for. Do shop for these. These are very important in your food photography. I also have some glass platters here. These can be used for starters. So these two platters are mostly used for starters, or you know, even sandwiches you all can plate into this one. Yeah. And so this is a glass bowl or a plate. You all can use it as a bowl or as a plate, whatever you all, however you all wish to use this. And it has a green color in it. I actually bought this one because it gives a good contrast to your dish. Because if you use darker colors, the contrast is more, the colors in the pictures are more, and it really creates a good effect in the overall picture. Now these are small glass bowls. these can be used for ingredients beneath, like you can just that you have used in the dish and keep it around, or even you can use it for raita or maybe something like that. Sometimes quite useful ones that I have. Cutleries. We are done with crockery. So these are the cutleries. So these are all antique cutleries. Here, right here. So you see, these are all ladles. Round ladle, flat ladle. Everything that you can use to keep in and around. You don't use this for cooking, by the way. Please begin. I got these from Chor Bazaar. They are very old and they are all blackened and all right now. So you don't use this for cooking, but you use it for as a prop when you're clicking pictures. Also, these are the spoons. Dessert spoons. Popped in color with the teaspoons, desserts and everything. These are my antique spoons. So this one right here, this one is another one. I use this the work. I don't know if you guys follow me or if you see my work, but you can always see my work on my Instagram. Are quite helpful. So all these different kinds of spoons I've bought from somewhere or the other, quite helpful ones. So now I'm gonna show you some of my backdrops. Sorry, I dropped some of the things. So also this one I forgot. This is a roti basket. This is usually used to keep rotis, or you can even keep papads in this if you're clicking something rice dish or something that papad goes with. So you can always use this roti basket. This is also a plate you can use, a big one, if you like you have created a big meal of something, like a lot of things, you can use this plate to click it with. I'll show you some backdrops. So this is one backdrop I'm using here. So this is called a surface, and actually this is called a backdrop. The black thing you see here is a backdrop, and when you put it down on the surface, it's called a surface. So these are some of my backdrops that I have bought. You use these different things. This is a textured paper. Not sure if you guys will know where to locate this from, but if you don't find it anywhere near you, just drop a text to me and I might help you with it. Or else you can always buy chart papers. So I'll show you the chart papers that I have. So these are the chart papers, normal chart papers that you might use for school as well. So you will get it in stationery. But be careful on about the colors. You need to buy like either light colors or maybe completely dark colors, but not something in between, because that won't help much. So these are the two colors that I have, violet and blue. Also the gray one, this one here is a chart paper. These two are chart papers, if you see. And always keep a black paper with you. Black chart paper, you will get it easily anywhere. So mostly, you can use this as your backdrop. It always gives a good picture to your, a good contrast to your photos, okay? So I have used a black one as well, but it's a little textured. Now these two papers are actually my favorites that I've bought recently. So this one you see here. So this is the front side and this is the back side. Now the back side you can use for normal food photography, but if you see the front, it's like it has too much of color. So now you can use this only for desserts. Like you can use it for cakes, you can use it for cupcakes and everything. Also, this is again a textured paper. It's brown in color. It gives a copperish kind of look if you see. It's transparent and a little different. It's not a paper, it's, I don't know what you call it, but I use it a lot. Also, this is a textured paper. It is yellow with some golden textures on it. And And then this paper, this you can use for cupcakes or some desserts. It'll really look very good. Yeah. So these were my backdrops, the things that I use the most. They are very important when it comes to a picture. You can of course put maybe a plain paper, plain dupatta or something, and use it. Like a plain dupatta would also do if you don't have any of these backdrops. Yeah. Thank you so much, Momita. So now we are coming to napkins. Yeah, because if you see, napkins also play a very important part in your pictures. So I have a collection of napkins as well. So these are normal cloths. You will find it anywhere in your area. So this is one. This is another one that I use the most. This is the most used cloth, okay, in my pictures. If you'll see, a lot of pictures have this cloth. Grey cloth, plain. It's plain. It's quite plain. Then there's this striped one. This is not what I'm wearing, guys. Please don't get confused between it. So it's a striped napkin. And this is your normal kitchen napkin, but guys, this helps a lot. Trust me. You can literally put it next to any of your dish and it would create a very good contrast it would give. Okay? So this is really helpful. You can get it in colours. You get it in a lot of colours. Like you will get green. This is a blue one. Quite easily available, yeah. So now I'm gonna tell you some. I forgot about this jute cloth, by the way. So this is also easily available. A jute cloth. It gives a very earthy look to your pictures. This creates a very, very good background. If you have a backdrop or a surface, you can use this. Like you can take a bigger one. You can spread it around and you can keep your dish in between and just click it using this as a surface. It will give a very good effect. Yeah. So now we are done with my props, my backdrops and my napkins. Now I'm going to tell you something about natural light. So right now I'm using a natural light. You see, this is not an artificial light. It's a natural light that's coming right from my door. I'm sitting in front of my, near my door, like, and the natural light, I usually use this place to click my pictures, because the pictures you get in natural light won't be the same in artificial light. You can always use artificial light if you're clicking in the night or something, but mostly try clicking during the day. So the artificial light would give a very good contrast to your picture. Also, you won't have to edit it much because natural light does the work. So also, if the natural light, if you see, it's too harsh sometimes, when if it's too sunny right where you live. So this is the thing that comes into work then. This is a diffuser. It's quite big right now. So this is a diffuser. It's used to diffuse harsh light. If you are getting harsh light on your food, you can always use this and reduce the light. Now if this comes with a reflector, if you don't have a diffuser, you can use a butter paper. Now you would find this in a stationery. So this is what is used to block harsh light on your dish. So you just, this is your dish. Suppose the light is coming from here. So you just keep it like this from one hand and click the picture to block the lights a little. So you can even fold it a little and hold it like this and block the light while you're clicking the picture. Yeah. So this is a very easily available thing. You might be using it for cooking as well. Like if you're into baking cookies and cakes and everything, so you might be using this a lot. And it's used in photography as well. Just for cooking, it is used for photography. If you see, if you are looking around here, so that is the things I use. So now, any questions regarding this? Because after this I'll be starting with showing you some angles into photography. So we'll be clicking some pictures of some dishes. Any questions? loving the simple things you are sharing to make things look stunning. Thank you so much, Sarita. Love your aesthetic sensibilities. Thank you, Aishwarya. I mostly use black, white and red color as backdrop. Yeah, you can always do it, Vrinda. You can always use black and white. They are very easily available and you can always use them. It's quite good. Can we use dupatta as backdrop? Of course you can use dupatta as a backdrop. A plain dupatta or even a dupatta with some design, but not too much of design. That would just lose it. Like the picture won't look as good. Steel plate, yeah. Cool. So now we will start. I have cooked some dishes and I'm gonna show you how to photograph those dishes. Very easy dishes and something that you might be making very often. And you can, I'll show you angles in which you can click. So basically there are three angles in which you can click a picture. So one is an overhead where you click the picture from top. Okay, so this is the dish. Suppose this is my hand is a dish. You click it from top, you will get a flat lay. It's usually called a flat lay, but also called an overhead. So this here is an overhead. This angle is called an overhead. Now, the same picture, the same dish, you are clicking from a 45 degree angle. This here, right here, is a 45 degree angle. Okay? And one important angle is the head-on angle. So, head-on angle, or you can say 90 degree angle, where the backdrop plays a very important role. Because you see here, you can see the backdrop. So it's very important to have a backdrop whenever you're clicking a 90 degree angle. Otherwise it's okay if you don't have a backdrop. You can only use surface. Okay, now I'll show the same things, the same angles to you with some cool dishes that I've cooked today. Yeah. So first we are starting with a pulao. My sister has made this pulao. I haven't made it. So this pulao you're gonna keep here. Now because, okay, this is my earthenware thing, okay, so it's a complete mitti ka bowl, by the way, guys. So it's very hard to handle and keep it cool. So be careful with such things. And this I'm using a Varli painted, again, earthenware. So now keep in mind, whenever you're using something of particular type, all the things around it should be of that same thing. Like if you're using an earthenware bowl, the small bowl around it should also be earthenware bowl. You can't use a glass bowl. You can use, of course, but it won't look good. Like you don't mix it up. If you're clicking something in a normal steel plate, everything should be steel. Like you can use a steel vati or something, but never like use a glass bowl and a steel plate. Don't mix up things, okay? When you're using antiques, use antiques, everything like that. So now, also one more important thing here is when you're clicking something like, so I made how to arrange ingredients that you're using. So mostly use ingredients which are used in the dish. Don't use anything apart from that. Okay. So I've made a pulao, so I can show you how to just place your props. So I'm using some of the spices that are used in this thing. So these are cinnamon sticks. I usually tie up the best ones with a jute thing, and you can keep it behind your photo somewhere, which it will be visible. Okay. Here I'm teaching you a 45 degree angle shot. By the way, I'm going to take a 45 degree shot with this thing. Now I'm using some garam masalas here. So if you see, all these garam masala are the perfect looking things. So next time you go for garam masala shopping, or if you get garam masala at your place, be sure to remove the best ones for your photography and use the rest ones. Okay? Don't use the good looking ones in your dishes if you want it to be photographed. Okay? So I'm just gonna place them around here. You see, I've used elaichi, I have used some cloves, I've used some black peppers around here. Okay, so you just place them around. You don't have to, like, you know, be very specific about it, that no, this should be in line and everything. You just mess around with it. Just mess around. It would create a better look when you mess around with it. Okay. So when you're clicking, when you're finally clicking the picture, now also I'm using this because who does not eat pickles with the pilau? And it does not have to be filled always because it's not gonna be seen. If you're keeping it open, fill it up and keep a small spoon inside it. It will create a good look. But I'm not gonna open it, so this is how I'm gonna just keep it here. Now also, if you see the dahi is plain here and it would not give a good effect to your picture. So I'll just sprinkle around some cumin powder. Sprinkle it around, don't make any designs, guys. It does not usually look good. So just sprinkle it around. Mess around with your ingredients always. So now your final placement comes into scene when you are looking at the picture on your phone. Okay? So now when I'm seeing the picture, I see there are some negative spaces. A negative space is something like an empty space. So I'll show you guys here if I'm clicking it like this. So if you can see, there's a negative, this is called negative space. There's no ingredient, like we have a lot of props, right? So use them. Okay, so this is a negative space. I'm going to fill it up a little bit now. So this here is my final picture of the pulao. If you see, I have filled a negative space by adding some cinnamon sticks to it. And over here, I have kept the pickle jar. I have used a bay leaf as well. Don't try to cover it like completely. Don't take the full leaf. It's always okay. You can see the main dish is on the highlight here. And also the dahi. Because it has to be in the frame a little properly. Okay. You see the pickle jar I have cut. But I have not cut the raita bowl. Okay, so you need to show things completely if you are focusing on it. Okay, so you can either click the bowl full or you can even do a zoom in. I'll show you a zoom in. So you can also click it like this. Okay, it's a 3/4 angle. 3/4 of the bowl is in the frame. Okay, so it gives a better look. Now look at the colors. So even when you're putting the pulao on your bowl, you should always have the main ingredients on top. Okay, so just, you know, maybe if it's all been covered with rice on top, you have to put all these things on top, like scoop it out, like this mirchi I have used, it's over here, like this bay leaf I have used, in it has to be on top, so it gives a better look to your overall dish. Okay, now so you all have seen this one. I'll clear it out. Now the next thing that I'm going to show you guys is a head-on shot. Okay, so for today's breakfast I had some dal vadas, and those dal vadas were amazing, and I thought I should keep them for a shoot. So today I'm gonna show those. Yeah, it's gonna be head-on shot. So now what I am using is a rolling, this thing, chakla basically, that you use to roll rotis. Yeah, so this I'm gonna use. This is, I'm showing you this because it's easily available at your home and it's quite a good backdrop, I would say. So I'm gonna keep this. I'm using a banana leaf because dal vada, South Indian food, so why not. So these aesthetics matter a lot, guys. When you're clicking something South Indian, you can go for this. If you're using a lot of curry leaves, you can always use curry leaves on a side. It gives a really good effect, yeah. So these are the dal vadas. So I'm just gonna place them on this thing. You don't have to be like line mein lagana hai and all that thing. You can just like keep it round. प्ले विद योर डिशेस गाइस. And one thing when it comes to such things, you know, tikkis or dal vadas or even cookies and all. Here's the last one. Just break it. So you see what's inside. Mostly when you cook tikkis, they are like stuffed tikkis or something like that. Kachoris, tikkis, they have stuffing inside, right? So it's always good to see what's, how does it look from inside, yeah? So this is how I'm gonna keep it. So just keep it around, or you can just, you know, keep one ear. It does not really matter. You should learn to play around things. Now I'm using my antique bowl for the chutney. Now if you see, the chutney looks very blank, right? Would you like to use such a thing? Would you like to show such a thing on your picture? So it's always better that you use something on top. Like, you usually temper your coconut chutney. So why not use a tempering for the photograph? So I've tempered some and kept. I'm just gonna pour it on top. Be careful not to spoil it. Use the main things a little more. So now we have our chutney and vada ready. I'm gonna click a head-on shot. I'm gonna show you how it looks. So now also, because the natural light is coming from this side, if I keep the bowl on this side, it would create a shadow on the dal vadas. So also you have to be quite careful with such things. So now long shot, this is called flat lay these days. So this is the shot that I've clicked. Yeah. So you see the chutney gives a better look completely. And these broken dal vadas side. Yeah. Tell me how, if you like the picture. Or if you have some tips for me, I would always appreciate tips or suggestions. Yeah. So now also, because we have used curry patta in it, now always be careful when you're using curry leaves. Use proper stems, not the ones that don't have proper leaves, okay? See this? Like, this is like a fresh one. So now I'll show you how to use a napkin. So it's not really necessary that you have to like properly fold it. Like, you just, you know, you have to be very careful using a napkin, fold it properly and then keep it. No guys, that is not how I use a napkin. You just do this and just place it, okay? Place it around your dish. See that it looks good, okay? If it looks good, just try and click it. Don't bother folding it or even ironing it. Some people literally iron the cloth and then they fold it properly and then they keep it on. That's not really necessary. So here. So if you see the shot, yeah. So it has a nap. I have also added a curry stem over here and the dal vadas here. Yeah. So it gives a better look. The napkin adds up a little to how it looks, you know. It covers a negative space. Yeah. So this is a head-on shot. A proper head-on shot. Yeah. I'll also show you guys in a while how to edit your pictures a little bit, yeah, basic editing I'll show. So this is how the cloth looks. See, if you fold it and everything, it does create a good look, yeah. So you just mess around with the cloth, you mess around with the dal vadas and with the tempering on the chutney, a curry, it's quite good. the wooden surface. The chakla basically gives a very good wooden surface right there. Yeah. So now I'm gonna clear these dal vadas as well. And I bake a lot of cookies. I love baking cookies. And I bake good cookies as well. That is what my family and my friends tell me. So why not like some cookies now? We'll change the surface. Yeah. Because this white surface, of course, it goes well with everything. But I do have a lot of backdrops and surfaces. So why not change it a little, give a contrast color to it. Give a contrast color to it and play with it. Yeah. So I'm going to use this. This is a textured maroon color background. I don't know which color you all can see on here. But this is a maroon color. Yeah. These can go well with even Indian curries. Yeah. I mostly cook my Indian curries on this backdrop. Gives a good color contrast. So yeah, also I'll give you a tip. If your surface is rolled like this, if you try and place it up like this, it just won't help you. It'll fold off. Yeah. So always turn it around. Roll your sheets inside out. Keep it here. You can just tug it in. So when I bake cookies, when most of the people who bake might have this plate, grill plate. Yeah, the grill plate that goes in the oven. It's very helpful when you can click cupcakes on this. You can click. Gives a very good effect. Like these lines, they look really good in pictures. So now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to use a butter paper on this. Yeah. So, I've cut this butter paper right here. Now, if you can always use it like this. You have to keep it in cross, by the way. Don't keep it. Always use it like this. But what will give a better texture to the picture is, crumpy. Just try and crumple it as much as you can, then open it. Now it has a crumpled texture to it, and just keep it here, right here. Okay, now we'll place our cookies. Now I have baked. Place the cookies. Now if you take a flat layer of this thing, always go. Thing is, right now I'm short of this thing. If you want to click a flat layer, I'll show. I have a picture of a flat layer as well. I'll show it to you guys. But right now we're clicking a flat head-on shot. So for head-on shot, choose your best cookie, the best one in the batch. There's always a best one in the batch. You can't disagree to that. So the best of my cookie is this one. Because you see here, it has a raisin right over here and over here. So it will give a very look good. It has raisins. It can be seen very visibly. So this is what I'm going to use the most. Like the focus will be on this cookie. Yeah. So you arrange it. You keep one or two of your best cookies here. Just like this. This, you just arrange the cookies. You keep a stack. Now what I'm doing for a head-on shot, because it's a head-on shot, there will be a stack. So there will be a stack of cookies. There will be a stack. This is a stack of cookies. Just four cookies stacked together. With the dal vada, do it with your cookie. Just break it, crumple it. Crumple it as much as you can. Use the crumples, yeah. So it crumpled a little bit. So I'm gonna use it to put it around, yeah. So just it gives a feel like your cookie is quite crumply, crunchy, crispy, everything. So you break it and you show it. So just keep this here, yeah. Now, what goes well with a cookie? You can maybe use coffee, milk, tea. What I'm doing here is using milk. Now, I've poured some milk in a cutting chai glass. So, it looks very good, trust me. So, I'm just gonna place this glass right here. So, because we're doing a head-on shot, a 90-degree shot, you see, you will be able to see a backdrop. So, the backdrop is very important when it comes to a 90-degree shot, okay? So, always have a proper backdrop. You can use a contrast one, so it gives a better look to it. Now, also, if you see, I have some raisins that literally came out of the cookie while eating them. So, I'm gonna use them. Always use these things. They matter a lot. I'm gonna keep it on the side and give you a good shot. So now always focus on this cookie. This cookie right here, the best. Focus on that. There's a stack of cookies on the back. And there's a glass of milk. See right here. So here's the picture that I just clicked. So this, the focus is on your cookie, the best one. There's a stack of cookies behind which shows how good they look. So you can see how nice and fluffy, and it gives a good thing. Now also there's a glass of milk. Now arrange things in a way that there's no negative space. Again, we don't need negative space. You can crop out this thing if you want. Yeah. And also the grill lines, you see, it gives such a good effect to the picture. So use your grill plate. It's very helpful, guys. Not just in baking, but also in clicking the pictures, yeah. Look, it gives a really, also the raisins here, you see. So these ingredients that you use as a prop for your picture matters, okay. So use them. Now I'll show you something. What you can do sometimes is, you can use human elements in your pictures. Human elements is when someone uses their hand in the picture, okay? Some people use their fingers. Some people use their hands like holding something and clicking pictures. So I'm going to show you a very simple trick right now where you can use a human element in the picture and you can do it by yourself. You don't need anyone else to come and help you with it. You're alone and you can do it by yourself also. So I'm going to take this half cookie right here. I'm going to dip it in the water, in the milk. And I'm gonna click it while I'm doing that. You can click it while you're doing that. You can take it out and click it. Yeah, you can do these things. So, you see how it matters. Yeah. So this cookie, I've used my hands in here and it creates a different effect. Now this one, I'm dipping it away here, and this one I've removed it and it has a few drops of milk around the cookie, if you can see. They are dripping from the cookie. So it gives a very good look when you use human elements. You can't use it all the time, but if you can, in some dishes you should. I'm sure you should. So this was the head-on shot, the overhead shot. Overhead, 45 degree and head on shot. Okay, so these are three very important shots, angles into photography. You can always do different angles, like you can, you know, just, I don't know, maybe 50 degrees, 80 degrees, it does not really matter. But when you come to photography basics, these are the three important angles that you need to learn and know about it, yeah. So also I'll show you a flat lay if you want. I have clicked it before, I'm not clicking it again, so I'll show you a picture that I've clicked. Those are different cookies. So these are my Jeera cookies that I've clicked before. If you see, again I've used the grill plate and butter paper and Jeera cookies on it. You can also do it this way. If you don't have a butter paper, you can use a napkin beneath the grill plate, so it would give that effect. And you can keep your cookies and some elements. See, I've used a rose tea over here. Okay, these are thumbprint cookies. I've used a rose tea over here and the jams that I've used in the cookies. So you can always use your props. Also, the biryani picture that I showed you, that was a 45 degree angle. Now I have flipped it as a flat lay in the steel plate that I told you guys about. So the same pulao, raita with some red chili powder and cumin powder, a salad with some lemon slice. The lemon slice plays an important role here because it's gonna add to your color. Yeah, some coriander stems, the fresh coriander around the plate looks really good, guys, trust me on that. And a grey napkin, just laid, not folded, just laid around, messed around. Yeah, you see a spoon with it. You can always use a cutlery. You know, cutlery plays a very important role when it comes to clicking Indian food, because most of the continental food won't need spoons. Yeah, pastas need forks. Yeah, so the placement is very important. You should be able to see the spoon. You can't just cut it and just, like, you know, just see the top of it. It won't look good. You need to see the stem of the spoon as well. Now also, one important tip that I would like to give you guys is, if you are preparing something like which has to be served hot, always keep it for the end. Like, prepare everything, your backdrop, your surface, the things that are gonna be around. Always prepare those things. Like, you're using, if you take an example of the pulao itself, so I use dahi and everything with it. Keep everything ready and then put the pulao on the bowl. Like, it should be hot. And then directly photograph it. You can't let the food sit there for long, because then you see the rice kernels will dry up and it would be seen in your picture. You don't want that to happen. So don't let the food sit for a long time. Be prepared with everything, and once everything is done, just get the food out and click it. You don't need to wait for anything. That is how I usually click my pictures. If you maybe chole bhature, you can say. So keep everything ready. Keep the chole in the plate. Just keep the plate there. Surround it with the things that you want with it. And then fry the bhature and get the bhature on your plate and click. So that the fluffiness of that bhature can be seen. The way it rises and everything. So you can see that in your picture. Okay? So also, okay, please show pictures with glass for liquid recipe. So what I'm doing right now is basically food photography. I am not much into beverage photography, but of course I can make a few beverage videos and share it with you guys, and you guys can go through it and tell me how it is. And also you can follow our page, and so that you can see more of my beverages pictures. Like, I'll show you one haldi wala doodh picture that I had clipped recently. Give me a minute. We will also, I can't find the picture right now. We will have workshops for that as well. If you want, what I can do right now is click a simple picture, like, of this glass of milk. I'll just keep it here. So usually what you do for glass photo, when you're clicking beverages, if you click it like this, just showing you an example of how it looks. You have to contrast the surface and the backdrop so that the glass looks good, the background of the glass looks good. Or else what you can do here, where usually when you're clicking beverage pictures, you can take the surface, fold it a little, you see what I'm doing here, just take it a little above, fold it a little, you can put a tape here, I'm not doing that right now because I'm just showing you a small example of how I'm doing it, and then click a picture. Okay, I need to use my first tip, my camera surface is stained, so I'll have to wipe it a little. Then you click a picture of that beverage. Then you see you have the same backdrop for it. Yeah, so your surface becomes your backdrop. If you fold it a little like this, be sure to tape it and don't fold. Be sure it does not have any wrinkles. Don't fold it, okay? No wrinkles. Just tape it here. Tape it right here. And use it as your backdrop and a surface. You can use a lot of elements in your beverage photography as well. I'll do a workshop about it soon enough, yeah? So now, the last thing I'm going to show you guys is editing. I usually use Snapseed for it. If you have Snapseed. So this is Snapseed. You can see it on Play Store. So Snapseed right here. Okay? So you can use Snapseed for your photo editing. Just open it. Tap a picture. So we'll use a picture that I clicked right now in front of you guys. So let's use Dal Vada picture maybe. We can use a Dal Vada picture. Now you don't have to go overhead with your editing things. So just go to tools here, right here. You go to tools, tune image. That's the first option, and that is what you need to use. You don't need to go overhead with it. Now, when you go to tune image, you'll see these options. There's brightness, there's contrast, there's saturation, there's ambience, there's highlights, shadows, and warmth. Okay, so these are the basic things that you need for your photo to look good. Now, we are using brightness. So, how Snapseed works is you have to slide it. So, if you see here, this is the highest brightness, this is the lowest brightness. So now always, if you are not sure, you can always do this. See how, which one looks better. So here, I'm gonna reduce it to 9, okay? Then just slide it, go to contrast. Now contrast, you can always have a little bit of more contrast to your picture. It makes the picture look quite good. Then you go to saturation. Now saturation usually increases the yellow color in it. Okay, if you reduce the saturation, it gives a blue color tint to it. Like you see what it does to the picture. Now this is a black and white picture altogether. If you reduce saturation, that is. If you keep it way too much, this is how it will look. It'll look yellow. Okay, so you don't want it too much. Saturation usually is around 7 to 8. That is what you need for your basic pictures. Now when you're using a foot mode in your phone, be careful with using the saturation. You don't really need to use saturation. You don't need to saturate your picture. Because a foot mode does saturate the picture while shaking it itself. Now ambience. Now ambience is how green. Ambience works with the green color basically. So keep the ambience around 8 or 9, okay? Not much. Highlights. So if you have clicked something that has plain rice on it, highlights would really help, because the white color, that even dahi or rice or anything white in the picture, so it, when it looks really very much white, you have to reduce the highlights so that the white is a little less. The white goes cools down a little, okay? So I've used a white background here. So I'm using to cut the very bright shadows. Now shadows do really work in the picture, but then sometimes the shadows are less and you don't want it to be seen. Increase the shadow thing. Okay, the shadows, I don't know if you all can see, but it's gone. The small shadows that it has. And sometimes you just need to reduce the shadows to give a more shadowy effect to your picture. Like these dal vadas right here are giving a little bit of shadow of the vadas. If you see here, it has small shadows and it really does add to the picture. So reduce the shadows a little, the shadows will darken up and it will look better. The last thing is warmth of the picture. How, if you increase the warmth, it turns a little bit yellow. If you reduce the warmth, it goes a little low on yellow and it turns a little bluish. You don't want a blue picture. So increase the warmth a little, around 10. Nothing more than 10, okay? Keep it 10, 11, okay? And that's how your picture looks. Just done, okay? Now you see, this was my picture before and this is the picture after. I have not edited it much because my phone's camera is quite good and it gives a really good effect by itself. I don't usually edit my pictures too much. So this is how it basically looks. This was before. It has the whites, you can see here, is too much. If you see in this picture, it's a little less. So the highlight, this is the highlighting. Also the greens, the ambience increase the green color and it looks quite good now. Yeah. So this is the basic editing that you need. So that's how I usually edit my pictures. You can also use some other apps if you are using. The basic things that you have to edit are brightness, contrast, saturation and sometimes warmth, because some pictures need to look a little warmer than they look in the picture. So use warmth, okay? And also when you're clicking something cold, like cold food, like a salad or something, the warmth should be a little less. It should not be too much. And when you're clicking something like that has to be served hot, you increase the warmth. It gives a good effect, like it shows that it is something garma garam kind of a thing. Yeah. So we are done with the basics of photography. If you all have any questions regarding anything, now is the time, guys. I'm gonna read some comments and answer most of the questions, or else I'll answer once I'm done with the session. I'll answer all your comments for sure. Thanks for giving us such a useful tip. Mostly I make curry, how can I show it? So Suman, I'll show you our page. Basically you can follow my page, and there are a lot of curries on my page. So this is one curry that I'll show you. Yeah, this is how you can click curries, like put it in a bowl if you want to show it with something, of course. You can use the plate right here. The focus is on the curry. If you see, it's on the curry. I've kept roti and rice with it, but the curry is on focus here. I have used the plate, the steel plate that I showed you guys, but instead of putting the curry over here where it is usually served, I put it over here so that it's more in focus. Yeah, because you all need to know what's in focus in your picture. And this is a 45 degree angle shot. This is a human element that I've used. I've used my sister's hand in this, like she is holding the plate. Yeah, human elements are very good for the pictures, so use them whenever you can. Yeah. When to use vertical or horizontal? So Bijal, I would say mostly use vertical pictures. They help a lot, vertical pictures, and usually when you upload it somewhere, it looks better, the vertical ones. Or you can always click horizontal pictures, not a bad idea. So this is a horizontal one that I had clicked, but then eventually I used just the vertical part of it. Okay, there are a lot, you can click horizontal pictures, but when it comes to food, try using the vertical thing only. Vertical looks better when it comes to food pictures. Yeah, I'll also show you a picture of it. Nice tips. Thank you so much, Bhumika. Thank you, Jaya. Thank you, Yoshita. Thank you so much. It's quite good to know that you guys are enjoying the session and you liked how I explained things. These are really basic tips. I am going to do a workshop soon, where you would know a lot more about this. Do DM me if you would like to join it. You will get to learn a lot more things. Yeah. Thank you so much, guys. This is a very good response. And also, I'll tell you guys, this is my first live session on Facebook, and this response has been amazing. I was a little tense about it, but the way you guys are loving it, I am really very happy about it. Yeah. Future, how can we contact you? Share page. So of course you can DM me on my Facebook Messenger always helps. My name is Chandni Mistri. Yeah, or else you can use our Instagram page right here. It's called Ma Beti Kitchen Chronicles. You can always DM me over here. I would help you out however I can. Whatever queries you have, you can share it. Yeah. My page link, आई वुड श्योरली शेयर माई पेज लिंक. सो माई मॉम हैज शेयर्ड माई पेज लिंक प्रगना मिस्त्री. इफ यू गाइज कैन चेक माई शी इज माई मॉम प्रगना मिस्त्री. शी इज द मा टू माई बेटी एंड वी कुक टूगेदर. शी कुक्स मोस्टली एंड आई क्लिक. दैट इज हाउ इट वर्क्स. सो या दैट्स इट. सो वी आर कमिंग टू एन एंड ऑफ द सेशन. And I would really love to host some more workshops for you guys. And Cookpad has been really very helpful in this thing. My mom posts a lot on Cookpad, but she is mostly into the Gujarati group. So y'all can check her recipes out there, and y'all can see more of my pictures right there as well. So that's the end to this session. I loved hosting the session for you guys. Do let me know if y'all need any more tips and anything. Yeah. After lockdown, soon we'll go to shop. At Chor Bazaar. Sure, do go to Chor Bazaar. They have a really lovely collection there. But you will need to be very careful while shopping from there. Bargain a lot. Yeah, bargain. And also go to a few shops before you finally plan to buy some things. Yeah, you have to be like, there are almost like 10 shops over there. Go to all the 10, explore everything, and then choose a shop where you would buy a thing from. Yeah. And everyone has a different collection, so of course, do whatever you can, yeah? Thank you so much, guys. Thank you. It was a great session. Thank you.